the pool that thing came from. The parasite now writhing behind your eye.
Might still be stuck inside if we hadn't been attacked.
To save us from this place. From this place you'll free us. Please. Before they return! They return. A newborn. Born new from this husk.
You realize you're talking to an intellect devourer. A minion of the mind flayers who abducted you.
Will be tainted and twisted. Within days, we will be Geth, mind flayers. We can do nothing until we escape. That must be our priority. First, we exterminate the imps. Then we find the helm and take control of the ship. We will address the matter of a cure for this infection once we reach the material plane.
to strike.
Time for stragglers.
The construction is too alien. Nothing looks familiar.
This ship is crashing. Do you intend to die for a stranger?
Try that contraption next to the pod. They did something to it when they sealed me in. Hurry! Please!
Appear in your mind, a brain, a Githyanki warrior, and centuries of darkness.
Skra, how many hosts are these Geh infected?
A dazed woman is trapped inside the pod. She doesn't notice you. Appears dormant. The console hums to life. Suddenly, you feel a hideous squirming in your head. A parasite. Then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. You feel the biomechanical. You feel the biomechanical.
Come on! Get me out of this thing!
biomechanical brain of the console
is crashing. Do you
come on? Give me up. Wait.
It cannot be helped.
The console hums to life. Nothing in the appearance of the device, but suddenly, then discomfort fades, and another sensation washes over you. Connection. Authority. You feel the biomechanical brain. A shiver runs across.
I thought that damn thing was going to be my coffin. Thank you.
Your mind lurches into her thoughts. Her gratitude is mixed with wariness, because you have a Gith with you.
You keep dangerous company. I did. It must be because of those parasites they put in us. They'll have to wait. I need to get off this ship alive first. Let me come with you. We can get off this ship and watch each other's backs along the way. Shadowheart. One moment. It's nothing. Trust me.
Enough of this chatter. We need to get to the helm. Now.
She's right. Lead on. Trust my own judgment.
Kanyank.
hold the knot.
Thank you.
As you wake, the tadpole squirms in your skull. The chaos of the crash site confuses the landscape. You'll need to find a settlement or landmark, and you'll need to do it quickly. The tadpole is a death sentence, and the clock is ticking. You need a cure.
You're alive. I'm alive. How is this possible? I remember the ship. I remember falling. Then nothing. No, I don't recognize this place. But anything's an improvement on where we just came from. First things first, we need supplies, shelter, and most of all, a healer. We might have escaped, but we still have these little monsters in our heads. You might want to reconsider calling her a friend. Looks like she ran off without us. We need each other. And we both know what's at stake. Can't think of better company. One thing, just before we go. I wanted to thank you again for freeing me. It would have been all too easy for you to run right past my pod, but you didn't. I'll remember that. Lead the way.
Fresh water. There must be a settlement somewhere nearby. More of those wretched things. Better stay back. One strike could be lethal.
our survival isn't such a distant prospect. Just a brief respite.
Looking ahead. Let's get going.
Still alive. So that's progress.
I've got one of those brain things cornered. There, in the grass. You can kill it, can't you? Like you killed the others? There. Can you see it?
Just a dumb boar. You're relieved until you see the flash of a dagger.
Don't we? I saw you on the ship, free, scuttling about. You're in league with them, aren't you? Those tentacles.
Your mind twists. You're looking out of unfamiliar eyes, prowling dark, busy streets. You try to hold the memory, but it fades to the worm. The light, the fear.
What was that? What's going on? The worm. Of course. That explains things, somewhat. And to think, I was ready to decorate the ground with your innards. Apologies. A kindred spirit. My name's Astarion. I was in Baldur's Gate when those beasts snatched me. My, my. You've been busy. So, did you learn anything about these worms while wandering the ship? Turn us into... Of course it'll turn me into a monster. What else did I expect? Although, it hasn't happened yet. If we can find an expert, someone that can control these things, there might still be time. You know, I was ready to go this alone, but maybe sticking with the herd isn't such a bad idea. And anyone that can crash a mind flayer ship and walk away seems like a good person to know. All right, I accept. Lead on. Well, hello.
Astarion's an interesting find. Let's hope any future acquaintances don't hold a blade to your throat by way of introduction. We haven't gone all that far yet. What are you referring to exactly? I suppose we'd go our separate ways. Not a slight on your company, of course. Perhaps. Perhaps not. If we do survive, we'll have separate lives to return to. I need to get to Baldur's Gate. There's someone waiting for me there. Someone I have to reach. As soon as possible. Let's just say it's a very personal, very private acquaintance. Must I? Thinking about it won't help. We know find a way to rid ourselves of these... We've no solid leads right now, though. If you discover anything that might help us, I'm all ears.
There. A mind flayer. And it's hurt.
That thing's bound to be dangerous, even if injured. Best be careful.
You approached the dying monster. This is the thing that abducted you. You could end its life here and now, if only you didn't feel compassion. Compassion. You can't move, can't think. Thinking is mercifully done for you. It will be a joy to serve, to die for it an honor. It's possessing your mind, forcing you to love it. But then the feeling slips. The creature's mind seems to focus elsewhere. The monster lies exhausted, defeated. Its eyes, wet orange pearls, radiate malice.
Death is too good for it.
Dead goblins over there. Worth checking for supplies, maybe.
What's going on with that room? Looks unstable somehow.
Approach the sigil on the stone. Magic glitters and swirls from it erratically, as if malfunctioning. It looks slightly dangerous.
A hand? Anyone? Just your average traveler stuck between realms. pull me out, and we'll get properly introduced. Hello. I'm Gale of Waterdeep. Apologies. I'm usually better at this. A bit shocked, but friend, it's a relief and a pleasure to make your acquaintance.
Say, but I know you, don't I? In a manner of speaking. You were on the Norse Lloyd as well. Then I can only assume you too were on the receiving end of a rather unwelcome insertion in the ocular region.
The insertee we speak of, this parasite, are you aware that after a period of excruciating gestation, it will turn us into mind flayers? It's a process known as seramorphosis, and let me assure you, it is to be avoided.
You don't happen to be a cleric by any chance, do you? A doctor? Surgeon? Uncannily adroit with a knitting needle?
You seem to know enough about our condition to realize it's beyond most clerics' skills.
Most, no doubt, but I find myself hoping to be in the presence of the few. You don't happen to be one of them. And it looks like we're both starved for our... We're most certainly going to need a healer. And soon, too. How about we lend each other a helping hand once more and look for a healer?
Most excellent! A parasite shared is a parasite halved. Or something to that effect. Oh, but before you think you're about to embark on a journey with most ill-mannered a man, thank you for pulling me out of that stone. It was an act of foresighted kindness, I assure you. I have the feeling ample opportunities will present themselves for me to return the favor.
Lost in thought.
stayed interesting.